you think of water, maybe you see it in a glass. You might imagine it in a lake. Or you might think of raindrops. But have you thought of where all this water comes from? You may be surprised to know that your water has probably been around the block a few times. That's right, you might be taking a shower with the same water you used last year. And how is that possible? Well, for 3.5 billion years, the Earth's water has been moving from streams, to lakes, to oceans, flowing underground, freezing on mountaintops, and forming the clouds we see in the sky. And all this moving and shifting around of water is one of the largest recycling efforts by Mother Nature. It's called the hydrologic cycle, and it's the driving force behind the weather we experience every day. When the sun warms the water on the Earth's surface, the water turns into invisible water vapor. This process is called evaporation. And every time water evaporates, it leaves behind whatever salts, pollutants, and other impurities were in it before becoming pure again. How did all that stuff get in there anyway? Well, that may be because water is the universal taxicab for pollutants. When water returns to the Earth as precipitation, whether as rain, snow, sleet, or hail, it may make several stops to pick up riders like pesticides, chemicals, trash, and even bacteria from something dead. Every year, over half of the 4.2 billion gallons of precipitation that falls on the continental United States evaporates immediately after returning to Earth. Talk about return to sender. All the rest of that precipitation becomes either surface water or groundwater. The weather will always impact how we get our water, but thank goodness it will never change the amount of water we have on Earth. We just need to get wiser about nature's water recycling program and do our part to make sure everyone has enough for life.